Good evening. We're here in the shuttle flight control room. The Orbit 3 team is on duty, and we've been taking opportunities throughout the last several nights to talk to some of the flight control team to learn about all the different individuals that support the operations. Joining us now is Tony DeBook, who is the shuttle ground navigator. This is one of the backroom positions supporting FIDO. Can you tell us a little bit about your job and what that entails?
Sure. The ground navigator supports the flight dynamics officer. They basically have three jobs. The first is called orbit determination. We take in measurements of the space shuttle and the space station from C-band radars, from the TDRS satellites. We process those, and with those we come up with an estimate of what orbit the space shuttle and the space station are in. We then take that state vector, position and velocity, and we give that to FIDO, and we use that for trajectory planning. We help FIDO do the trajectory planning maneuvers, reboosts, docking and undocking times, things like that. The last piece of that is the onboard computers also have an estimate of their orbit, and that periodically needs to be updated. And so we monitor the health of that particular vector, and we send up a new one when it needs to be updated. So that's kind of a nutshell of what navigation does.
And so that's during the mission, you're supporting 24 hours a day?
24 hours a day, yep. There's usually two of us back there during shifts like this. There's two of us back there when for more complex shifts like rendezvous or for post-insertion, there'll be more people back there.
Wow, so there's two at the quieter times.
That's right.
Okay, that's interesting. And you were telling me that you are also duly certified now for a position in the space station room?
I'm in training for, I recently moved over to the Trajectory Operations and Planning Group on ISS, and I'm in training for their first, I'm doing the first level certification for that. Eventually I'll be a front room controller.
What kind of parallels are between those two positions? I'm imagining there's some skills or traits from this job that will carry over.
There are. The TOPO position, which that's the acronym of it, is largely analogous to what the FIDO does. So they monitor the trajectory of the space station. They do the planning, like for instance, planning of reboosts. They coordinate with Moscow because there's an equivalent position over in Moscow that does trajectory as well. They also obviously need to know what the most current estimates of the orbit state are, and so they kind of brought me in because of my experience in navigation, because they've largely gotten that from external sources prior to this time.
It's always just neat to hear about the crossover between the two teams. You guys are work pretty closely, you know, on a normal basis, but you're going to be literally crossing over to that team.
Exactly.
Why don't we start from the beginning? Tell us about your upbringing and what brought you on this path to working at NASA.
Okay. I was originally born here in the U.S., but when I was only a couple weeks old, we moved to Geneva, Switzerland, where my dad had his first job. And so we lived there for about 4 years, and then we moved back to the United States, again because of my dad's job, and we moved to just outside the Washington, D.C. area in Northern Virginia. So that's largely where I consider myself to have grown up, is in Northern Virginia. And when I was in elementary school, I watched the first space shuttle launch and landing in school. It was a big deal. It obviously made a big impression on me. When I was in junior high, I made the decision that I wanted to work in human spaceflight. And I kind of set a goal for myself to do that. Coupled with that goal, I said I was going to do well in science fairs. And so in high school, I went to Bishop O'Connell High School in Arlington, Virginia. And that was one of my big focuses during those 4 years, was to really excel in science fairs. And I did, numerous awards and things like that. After I graduated from high school, went to Cornell University up in Ithaca, New York, studied mechanical engineering for my bachelor's, aerospace engineering for my master's. After I graduated from Cornell with my master's, I went to Purdue University for 2 years, doing postgraduate work in the aerospace department. after I left Purdue, I joined a company called Iridium. They're a satellite telephone company. They've got a constellation of 66 satellites in low Earth orbit, and basically you can have a telephone that works anywhere in the world. So I did orbit determination for them for about 2 years. And some of the people that were in that group used to work at navigation here at JSC. And so it was just a really good connection to have, so that when I left Iridium, I came down to JSC about 10 years ago, and joined the navigation group. And I've been doing shuttle nav ever since.
Well, now that you're in the position that you've been dreaming of for years, tell us, what do you like most about this job?
The people, definitely the people. You have people from all different backgrounds, different faiths, different experience levels, all over the United States, all over the, you know, even some international, and we're all kind of here with a common goal. We're all kind of focused on that goal of human spaceflight, and I think the teamwork is really the best part.
What do you find is the most hardest, the hardest aspect of your position?
I think the hardest part is the shift work. I like to joke that I pulled more all-nighters in my career than I ever did in my education. So you get into a rhythm eventually with the hours, but it does present its challenges.
So you said that, well, I think what's fascinating is that at such a young age, you kind of identified that this is something you wanted to do.
Mm-hmm.
You have some other advice for young students who maybe at a young age think this is something that interests them?
Sure. Common element, of course, is you've got to study something like engineering or science or math. I would have three other things that I would say would be kind of good in my experience to pursue. One is set a goal for yourself, even set some sub-goals and stay focused on them. I think in today's day and age, it's very easy to get distracted by many different things, and if I look at my life, the thing that really set me apart, I think, was having that goal and sticking to it regardless of what other people said. Second, get a mentor. Someone that's in your field that can share their experience, their skills, and even provide you encouragement. I've been very fortunate to have some very good mentors in high school, in college, and in the workplace, and that has made all the difference. And last, keep faith that if this is where God wants you to be, then He's going to make it happen. Certainly, it takes a lot of hard work to get here, but in my experience, there are just some things that my hard work did not. There's some things that happened that were not as a result of my hard work. They were just blessings from above. So.
Well, we're really glad that you ended up here and pursued your dreams.
Yeah.
Thanks so much for sharing your story and some great advice. That again from Tony DeBook, who is a shuttle ground navigator, one of the backroom team of experts here at the Johnson Space Center.
Thanks.